Assalamu alaikum, grade 1, and welcome to your social studies class. I am your ma'am Omama, and in today's class we will be revising whatever we have covered in this week, right? Okay, so who is going to tell me what was the topic we covered in this week? Yes, we talked about healthy food, and then we also talked about how we can keep ourselves neat and clean, right? Okay, so tell me, what were the from where did we start our topic? We start with what does healthy means, right? To keep yourself, and who is going to tell me the definition of healthy? To keep yourself fit, both physically and mentally. Very well done. Okay. Then we talked about the healthy food items, right? And we also made a diet plan for ourselves as well, remember? So tell me, what were the things we included in that? We included fruits, fresh fruits, okay. Vegetables as well, then cereals, excellent. What else? Do we included any junk food in that? No. Why? Because it's not healthy, right? Okay. Do we included any bakery items in that? Any baked items? No. Why? Because they only make us obese. Excellent. Then we also talked about another thing that was important to keep us healthy was exercise, and I show you a video for that as well. And we talked about some basic exercise that all of us can do. Let's say we discussed that everyone can walk, all of you can do some jogging, right? Then we also discussed that you guys can go and play in the play instead of playing video games over the mobile phones or over the computer. You can go outside and do some physical work, some physical activities in the playground. Beside that, we also talked about playing badminton, playing football, doing some cycling and all that, right? Okay, then we talked about the next topic that we covered in this week was how can we keep ourselves clean, right? And we also made a link of that cleanliness with the good health. So tell me, how do we define cleanliness? Yes, cleanliness means keeping yourself and the area around you neat and clean. Very well done. And what do that area includes? Your home, the area where you live, the area where you walk, where you eat, where you sit, everything, right? Okay. So tell me, what were some basic activities, some basic things that we should do on daily basis to keep ourselves neat and clean? Yes. Combing our hairs, brushing our teeth, taking a bath. What else? Wearing neat and clean clothes, right? Okay. Cutting our nails, very well done. What else? Think about it. Properly disposing the garbage, right? Okay, now that was all that we covered. And then we also talked about what are the diseases that we can get if we do not keep ourselves neat and clean, right? So what were those diseases? Diarrhea, okay. Skin diseases, influenza, right? Stomach pain, or anything related to your stomach, right? So all of these things happen as a result of? Yes, if we do not keep ourselves neat and clean. Very good. So now I'm going to share the screen with you. There are some activities that we have discussed in our yesterday class as well. These are the activities that we should do in our daily life to keep ourselves neat and clean, right? We discussed this. Now for every activity, a small word is written, or therefore a small heading type thing is written. Let's say oral hygiene, bathing ritual, hair care, but not the proper sentences. What you are supposed to do, by looking at this picture, you are supposed to create a paragraph, right? Write all of these sentences in the all of these things in the proper sentence form. Make a sentence for yourself that what is the importance of health and hygiene, right? Or let's say, what are the daily activities that we should follow to keep ourselves healthy and clean? So you would be making sentences out of these all things. I'm giving you this hint. You can make some other sentences as well. If you want to skip anything, you can do that as well. Okay. But do start writing. Give the heading as importance of health and hygiene, or how we can keep ourselves healthy, and then start making sentences. Let's say the first one is oral hygiene. So and you can write it as, in order to keep ourselves healthy, we should look after our oral hygiene and we should brush our teeth. Or you can, instead of oral hygiene, you can write this as, we should brush our teeth before and after eating, or early in the morning and before going to sleep. Okay, this is not important that you are supposed to use these words. You can use your own as well. So hurry up, start writing. Remember, we discussed about coughing and sneezing, and I told you that this is very important to always cover your mouth during coughing and sneezing. Why? Because it avoids spreading of germs. Excellent. You can write 2 to 3 sentences in home hygiene as well, that we should keep our room neat and clean. We should keep the area where we sit and eat neat and clean, right? So do this. We should also arrange everything in a properly manner, right? Okay. Do write sentences. All of you are done? Should I stop sharing? Okay. Show me your work one by one. Excellent. We did the exercise in yesterday class as well, right? And there were some true and false questions. Okay, it's a class because we have already finished the chapter. So I didn't start a new topic. Why? Because in tomorrow's class, you will be having a small weekly assessment. So I wanted to revise each and everything in order to make yourself prepare for the assessment. And if you have any question, any query related to that, you can ask me right now so that I can explain this for you again. And then in tomorrow's class, you will be having a small weekly assessment. I'll include each and everything. I can ask you to read a small part of the chapter, right? So do reading that as well. I can ask you to define something, right? Like we define cleanliness, we define healthy, right? So all of these terms, do revise that, but I don't want you to memorize the definitions that I told you. You are supposed to create your own, right? I would always appreciate you if you would write something from your own, but do write them in a proper manner, right? It should be right. Okay. Now, beside that, I can give you true false as well, which are there in your exercise. Your exercise is also important. Do revise each and everything. And I can ask you to make the pictures of that as well. Let's say I can ask you that there are some daily activities that are important to keep ourselves neat and clean. Like I show you a picture of that, right? I can ask you to write a paragraph on that and also make the pictures of that activities. Let's say over here, a girl, she is wearing clean clothes. Over here, he is combing his hair. She is cleaning her ears, right? So I can give you this activity as well. So do look at each and everything. Got it? Hope you guys enjoyed the lecture. I'll be seeing you tomorrow, inshallah. Take care and Allah Hafiz.